This is the story of Base. Let's start from the beginning. As you will see, technology and Base go hand in hand. Before there was technology, there were men with deep voices. This is the origin of Base. In the 14th century, Base made a giant leap forward with the pipe organ. Its bass pipes can be as long as 64 feet. Around the 15th century, advances in string technology allowed for longer and stronger strings. This gave us the first string basses. At about the same time, bass instruments that players blew into to produce bass started to pop up. You're probably thinking of the tuba, but that famous bass instrument didn't show up until the mid-19th century. The first bass wind instrument was the serpent. The biggest serpent was called the anaconda. The sousaphone is a type of tuba that players can play while marching. The mid-20th century introduced electricity to bass. Two new bass instruments entered the bass family, the synthesizer and the electric bass guitar, and their companion, the bass speaker. Music didn't feature the bass until the mid-18th century. Advances in technology made it easier to play these big instruments. The first bass superstar was Domenico Dragonetti. He was friends with Beethoven. The small jazz combo of the mid-20th century introduced bass fans to a new set of bass stars. Each player in the jazz combo was featured, so the bass player could not hide in the background. There were many new bass stars during this time. Paul Chambers, who played bass with Miles Davis, was one of the best. Bass took a new role with the musical style rock and roll, and that was to make music fans dance. This was called boogie woogie bass. Elvis Presley's bass player, Bill Black, introduced the world to bass that made your body want to move. The dancing didn't stop, and after rock and roll came soul music. In the 1960s, James Jamerson added jazz concepts to rock and roll bass. He played bass on almost every song that came from the famous Motown recording studio in Detroit, Michigan. Soul music wasn't enough to get James Brown dancing, so he invented funk. This music was centered around the bass. His bass player, Bootsy Collins, really knew how to make people dance. Although the story continues, we will end with the 1970s. Jaco Pastorius taught music fans that bass wasn't just about making people dance. He mixed jazz, soul, and funk, and featured the bass guitar as a solo instrument.